Hello everyone, I welcome you all to CADNEST online classes. CADNEST is an ISO certified computer training institute. The managing director of CADNEST is Mr. Prakash Hachim sir. The courses we offer is CAD courses, accounting courses, development IT courses, digital marketing and animation. We are located at four different branches, that is CADNEST Rajajinagar, CADNEST Baswangudi, CADNEST Seshadripuram and CADNEST Malleshwaram. And for today, we are going to study about TDS in TAL. TDS stands for the Tax Deductions at Source, which is a procedure wherein we deduct a tax from the individuals in a company. Example, there are five heads of income as per income tax, that is income from house property, income from salary, income from business or profession, income from capital gains, and income from other sources. So, out of this income, if you are earning more than the limits, then you are liable to pay the taxes to the government. It is as per the IT Act 1961 and it comes under the section 192, that is TDS under section 192. So, and then when it comes to the salary, if you are less than 60 years and if you are earning more than 2.5 lakhs per annum and you are liable to pay the TDS. And if your age comes under 60 to 80 years and if you are earning more than 3 lakhs per annum then you are liable to pay the TDS. And the TDS rates are 10% per annum and as of now they have converted this into 7% due to this pandemic situations. And on every month you will have the TDS deductions. So that is the procedure we are going to study now. We will not get into each and everything at a time. So, we'll study any one of the heads of income and its TDS deductions so that all the heads works the same. Yeah, let's begin that with the company creations in TALI. As always, instructor will create a new company in TALI just for the work of TDS. Create company. I'll create the company as TDS itself. And select the state as Karnataka. So observe this, the financial year is 1/4/21. We have to follow the same dates throughout the procedure of TDS. And I'm into the configuration screen. I have to configure whatever that is required for my company. As if now I don't want the GSTs. So enable GSTs will be no and enable TDS at source should be yes. And later on have to furnish the details relating to that. Now I can see as a TAN registration number. TAN registration number means it is a number through which reference we are going to make a payment of taxations and the deductions of taxations. TAN number format goes like 4 alphas, 5 numerics and 1 alpha. And in the next slide, it is asking me for again tax deductions in collections account number, that is again TAN, repeat the same number. So deductor type is individual or HUF because for one of the employee in the organization, I am deducting the tax not from any of the companies elsewhere. So that deductor type is an individual. So you can give branch or divisions and other details. Set alter the detail of person responsible, yes, and I have to give the details of that person from whom I am going to deduct the taxes. And or you have to give the PAN number, format of PAN number is 5 alphas, 4 numerics, 1 alpha. Fee is compulsory at the place of PAN number of an individual. So ignore IT exemption limit for TDS, yes. Because I'm not giving any exemptions, the entire amount is taxable here. And active TDS for stock items, no. Accept this configuration screen so that we are done enabling TDS in my company. And the very next work we have to do is creating the ledgers. To create that, we'll go for create and ledgers. The very first ledger is tax ledger, that is TDS under the group duties and taxes. The type of duty is TDS. So if you have multiple duties and taxes, that is it might be GST, TDS or any service tax, you'll have all the list. So according to your nature of taxes, you have to select the type of tax. And any tax it might be, when it comes to creation of ledger, you have to group them under duties and taxes. Nature of payment. As I have told, there are 5 heads of income. Out of that, whichever the head of income you are working with, you have to create that under the nature of payment. So go for create. Name. So as I have told you, we'll take the professional incomes example. So TDS on professional income. Under the section 197, payment code is nil, and with PAN, I'll go with the example of 10%. It's like if you provide your PAN details, the tax deductions rate will be less. If you don't provide your PAN details, the tax deduction rate will increase. That is a criteria under all taxation system. And resolved exemption limit is nil because I'm not giving any exemptions. The entire amount is taxable. Accept this. And next is a party ledger is what I'm going to create. Under the group sundry creditor. And under current liabilities it will get divided into, because my company is liable to pay that salary amount to this person in the future. That is why. And maintain balance bill by bill? No, because I don't want the reference. And is TDS deductible? Yes. So if this employee is liable to pay the TDS, this option should be converted into yes. If the other person in your company is not liable to pay the tax, then this option will be no. So deductive type is individual HUF. If he is resident, you can go for resident. If he is not resident, you can go for selecting non-resident. Deduct TDS in the same voucher? Yes. And also have to furnish some more details relating to this, as that is not displaying me the options. Go for Control I for more of the options in tally. Your TDS applicability? Yes. And I have given deductive type as individual HUF. Deduct TDS in the same voucher? Yes. That is for the nature TDS on professional income. If you have multiple incomes TDS, you can select them accordingly. Use advanced TDS entries? Yes. And ignore surcharges? Yes, because I am not charging a surcharge for this. Ignore IT exemptions? Yes, applicable whenever I am charging the TDS on professional income. Set alter the details? Yes. The nature of payment is TDS on professional income. The section number is 197 and applicable from 1/4/21 to 31st March 22. And remember, if you create the date or if you create the company at the date 1/4/21, this applicable date should also be at 1/4/21 itself. That is for next year, you have to change the dates accordingly. The rate I have taken 10%, so we have to give the same percentage here also. And accept this screen so that we are done with creating party ledgers also. And later, only and only if he earns salary, he can go for deducting the tax. So that is why his salary's ledgers should be created. Under the group indirect expense, because if my company is paying the salary or professional income to the employee, it is an expense for my company. So indirect expense group. Is TDS applicable? Yes, it is applicable. Nature is TDS on professional income. So three ledgers we are done creating that are required for TDS work. The tax ledger, the person's ledger, and the person's income ledger. I get back to Gateway of Tally screen. Now I have to enter the vouchers. So go for transaction vouchers option. Here we have to enter journal voucher. F7 is the shortcut key. So we have different vouchers for different entries. For example, if we pay for anyone, we'll go for payment voucher. If we receive money, we'll go for receipt voucher. If I sell something, I'll go for sales voucher. If I purchase something, I'll go for purchase vouchers. So just like that, we have the journal voucher. Journal voucher records accounting events that cannot be recorded on any other mass document. They can be used to close accounts, move money, adjust balance. In some instances, the journal voucher is used to record adjustments to previously entered transaction. So now the salary we have already previously entered in my company. But now I'm adjusting that once in a year for the purpose of TDS. That is why we are getting into the journal voucher. First, in the journal voucher, we'll go for debiting the professional income, because debit all expenses and losses. So we'll take an example of 4 lakhs rupees, and out of that credit the name of person, so that I'll have the balance amount to be credited to his name, and to see the remaining amount, credit TDS. For the TDS, they have deducted 80,000. The remaining amount that is payable to Mithun is 3,20,000 out of the salary 4 lakhs rupees. That is what is meant by this. So accept this screen. To analyze this now, we'll get back to Gateway of Tally screen and balance sheet. In the balance sheet, to have the detailed view of the entries, go for Alt F1 function key. On the liabilities column, I have duties and taxes 80,000. This 80,000 rupees, my company is not liable to keep it for himself. My company is liable to pay this amount to the government. So that is why it is under the liabilities column. And sundry creditor, this amount should be credited to that person's bank account. So we'll do that also. Give escape, come back to Gateway of Tally screen. To make the payment to the government, we'll go for vouchers. F5 payment voucher. To autofill the TDS entries, Control F is the shortcut key. The type of transaction is start payment, tax type is TDS, period. As always, company creation date and taxation date and this autofill date, everything should be same. So my company creation date was 1st April 21 to 31st of March 22. So take the same date and deduct till 1/4/21 itself. And under the section 197, nature is TDS on professional income, deducting status. So it is from individual, so non-company. Residence and cash, so that whatever the tax amount we have formed in the form of deduction will get auto-filled into my payment voucher and you will accept this. So that's it. That's it for the TDS entries. If you do this much of work, you are done with the procedure of calculating taxation. And that taxation, you have made payment to the government. And that's it for the day. In tomorrow's class, we'll learn about TCS, that is Tax Collections at Source. We'll meet you tomorrow. Thanks for joining. Bye.